afternoon, Conemaugh Township.
Attention all students. Prior to leaving today, you are to place your Chromebook in the assigned cart. The Google account of any Chromebook not placed in the cart will be suspended until you turn it in.
Cafe 118 is selling cake pops today during lunches for $1.
All juniors should now have received their SDS packets from Mrs. Kimmel, and all purple proposal forms are due at the end of the school day on May 30th. Please see Mrs. Kimmel with any questions.
Attention students entering grades 7 through 9. CT's basketball program is offering a summer basketball camp. The camp will occur June 3rd through 7th from 9 to 12 each morning. The cost for the camp is $100 and sibling discounts are offered. Registration is due by Friday, May 31st to Mr. Lesko. Don't miss out on this opportunity.
Today's Daily Boost is... It's Friday and almost the start of summer. You just relax and enjoy this weekend coming up, and don't let anyone steal your sunshine.
See you never. Attention students entering...
It's rude.
Okay.
We're going to
everybody. Say see you never. Okay. Not sad.
Are you ready now? Good afternoon, Colin.
I would just like to say thanks to everybody who's watched this, and I would also like to say whoever reads the Daily Boost next year, make sure to make it more enthusiastic than I did, if you can try, and good luck.
I just want to say make sure that you do things right and don't screw it up.
Tribe with Kendra
and Allison.
Welcome back to the Middle School Tribe with Kendra
and Allison.
Welcome back to the Middle School Tribe with Kendra
and Allison.
Hey guys, it's Kendra
and Allison,
and this is our last time ever on the Contownian, formerly known as the Tribe.
We would like to thank you guys for all the support, and a special thanks to Mrs. Feathers for continuing this program and being willing to learn with us.
Well, that's all for this week. Have a safe summer and don't forget to be kind.
Don't do anything we wouldn't do.
Thanks for watching. See you next week.
See you sometime.
You heard about the soccer camp this summer?
No, it didn't tell me about it.
It's a summer camp at the end of June for ages 5 to 12 at the elementary school.
Really?
Yeah.
How exciting.
Super duper exciting.
That's awesome.
If you guys show up, you get to train with the D5 champs.
That's awesome. I'll be there. You better too.
I'll be seeing all you there, correcto?
Be there, be square.
I don't know if you've heard this before, but...
Big time campers.
Show up to.
Big time camps. Be there June 24th. CT Little Indian Soccer Camp. All are welcome.
Extra bright, I want y'all to see this. Turn up the lights in here, baby. You know what I need, want you to see everything.
So, as you can see, we got three, they look like water. Regular water, right? Right? If you shine in that one. See, the laser's a little bit purplish, so it looks purple. Just like the laser. But in that one, it's also purple. But you check this one out. Completely different color, a super light blue. Almost looks like Gatorade or something, so really cool. We go to these three oils. I think it's vegetable oil and olive oil.
This one's vegetable oil.
But it turns red. Why does it turn red? Physics. Go to this one. It turns white. Why does it turn white? Physics. And this one, well, it's kind of gray, blue. Physics.
I plan to be like an environmental engineer, so physics is going to be a lot of what I'll deal with. The math portion of it.
Recently we did a gummy bear lab, and we got to see how we built a whole bridge out of gummy bears, and we got to see how they rotated according to waves, and how that kind of bridge structure would not work very well. So it was really cool to see the pulses of the waves through gummy bears.
Probably when we were learning about different waves, and we had to build a bridge out of gummy bears.
My favorite lesson to teach this year was about momentum and impulse.
we go ahead and start it off with a demo throwing an egg into a bed sheet. It's really, really difficult to break. That also helps us to go ahead and see how does physics apply in the world. Whenever we do the egg drop project, we talk about how is physics designed in the cars and keeping us safe.
Hopefully next year we can come back and cook a lot better. Do a little bit less than that in the summer. Yeah, any words you want to say?
Yeah, I had a great time having these guys in my room. They were always polite, respectful, clean up after themselves, and I enjoyed listening to them back and forth banter with each other, and yeah, it was a good time. Can't wait to have them again next year.
See you guys next year.
This does the job, so I don't need a stand-up.
Good.
When I see her, I swear.
Oh my.
For this
Jordan, shut up!
I'm sorry!
Your eyes match your shirt.
That stuff nice.
Soft! Especially if you film me.
Very quiet.
Is it on?
And get more pretzels, right?
More pretzels.
Right up.
I'm good with that.
Chicken tenders with dip or
coleslaw.
No.
Wait, I want to be in it.
No. No.
I want to be in it.
Help.
Hey, what's up, you guys?
Yes.
Hey, what's up, you guys?
Yes.
Hey, guys.
She rose up personal finance, and here's the best part. It's not even that hard.
Hey, Robbie. Who's peeking at me?
Everybody had that.
What do you look like?
No!
Spider-Man.
Hi, Zach.
What I miss most about CT. Well, first off, I want to miss this guy right here, Big Sam Thomas. Second off, all the teachers, everybody that has been so kind to CT. Yeah. Just all the students, man. It's gonna be a crazy next couple years. Get ready to figure out what this is gonna be fun. Ready, Sammy?
John Deere Green.
What I'm gonna miss most about CT is probably going to the fun basketball games and being a stat girl, and also seeing Mrs. Feathers every day and being in her class all day.
I'm gonna miss Emma. Emma, what are you gonna miss? She's gonna miss me.
I'm gonna miss
playing volleyball the most and seeing all the teachers up there. Thank you. All right, Sam, what are you going to miss the most about CT?
Know what to look for. Up to the east, you can still read his words of love. And John
out, hey, Samuel, you at me, Samuel.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want it forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I'm shutting down in the mall and telling that girl she the one for me. And I ain't even planning to call. I want it forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine.
Welcome back to the very last week of Township Sports. Sad one, I know, but hey, summer's here. Izzy's at a track meet right now.
Izzy's at a track meet right now, so I'm filling in. I don't really know what I'm doing.
But let's get into it. On Tuesday, the baseball team played their first game of District 5 playoffs with a win 50-0 against Turkey Foot. Blair Weaver and Luke Haight combined for a no-hitter. And good old Luke Weber, Denser, hit a home run. Grand slam. Attaboy, Denser. Attaboy. They also played a game yesterday. Results are posted on the Facebook page, Conwell Township Athletics. And she's going to talk to you about some softball.
We won a single game this season. And it was a mercy roll, which is crazy for us. Lost every single other game. That's it.
You guys, what were the ups of the season besides that win?
The ups of the season were our coaches. They're great, and they didn't yell at us that much, which probably was a bad thing. Also, Brittany can bake, so we had a lot of baked goods at practices. Not a whole lot of running. Didn't condition once. I don't think I ran once except for running the bases, and still I thought I was going to throw up during those. And Taylor Jarvis, shout out to her. She was our pitcher. And shout out our senior, Haley Thomas. She was also great, and she was a backup pitcher, and she ate.
Good luck to the track team this weekend at Shippensburg. There's a lot of people out there for states, you know.
Izzy, good luck. I love you.
But, yeah, it's been a fun year, a long year, lots of ups and downs. Still a little sick from last week, but...
I wouldn't know. This is my first time doing this, and it's hot in this room.
It is. I'm sweating right now, but... I'll see you guys next year.
I won't.
You might.
I might.
Cook off. But, yeah. See you guys next year.
Hello, class of 2024, and anyone else watching. For a while, I wasn't sure if this video was going to be finished. I didn't want to put out a bad product. But it's here. So I hope you laugh, cry, and smile. First, let's hear from our teachers.
Well, you made it. And a lot of you, I wasn't so sure about. But since you finally completed everything that was required of you, I wish you the best of luck. And I know you guys are going to be ridiculously successful no matter what you guys get into. We will miss you. And again, congrats and good luck in the future.
Congratulations, class of 2024. Remember, this is only a small chapter of your life that is coming to a close. The plot of your story is just getting good. So although we will miss you, we are eager to see the next chapters unfold. Best of luck. Hey, class of 2024, you guys are a special group. 4 years ago, we had to end our school year early. We missed spending the best part of the school year together, but we did make the best of it. I'm sure you'll never forget those weekly show and tell Zoom meetings with Mrs. Feathers and me. Haley, remember your ducklings? I do, they were cute. Time sure does fly. I'm so glad I got to know you guys and work with so many of you again as seniors. It's going to be so hard saying goodbye to all of you. A little piece of advice, get out there. The world is big. Meet new people, see new places. Home will always be here. Remember, once an Indian, always an Indian. I wish you guys the best. Happy graduation. You did it. Congrats, guys.
Is that good?
That was perfect.
Woo! To the graduating class of 2024, my first group of seventh graders at Conama Township, I just want to put one thing out there to you. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to screw up. You're going to let yourself down. You're going to let down the people that you care about, and it's going to hurt. You're just going to feel disappointment and anger and frustration, and all of that's okay. What really, really matters is that you take all of those mistakes and that you learn from them. You pick yourself back up, and then you keep going. Because you have a lot of people who love you and who are counting on you to succeed. Congratulations, class of 2024. That's it.
To the seniors of 2024, I want to wish you best of luck out there in the real world. Those of you going on for your education, remember to develop a work ethic that is second to none. Go to class. Those of you that are pursuing other avenues of happiness, best of luck, same advice. Go to work, and work hard, have fun, and live life to the fullest. Congratulations.
To the class of 2024, I would just like to tell you that it has been an honor and a privilege to watch you growing up, to be with you from sixth grade all the way to 12th grade, to watch you grow from little kids to adults and people that I really like and people that I would talk to on the street when you're not here anymore. And I think you're all, you're gonna be good people. You're gonna make it. If you don't stay here with us in Conama Township, wherever you end up, please just try to make your community a better place. Please just try to help others no matter where you are with whatever gifts that you have. And if you get tired or you get discouraged, learn to rest, but not to quit. We're proud of you, we'll miss you, and make sure that you keep breathing.
Good luck. Secondly, work hard, and you guys will make mistakes, and that's fine, that's part of the process, but try to avoid making the same mistake twice.
Thanks to all the teachers who chipped in for that. I remember a few teachers throughout my time here at Conama Township. It really shaped who I am. Sadly, Miss Stankin has moved on to bigger and better things, so she wasn't here to include in that video, but I'm sure if she was, she would give some pretty good advice. I know that sometimes the world doesn't appreciate our teachers, and I know sometimes as students we definitely don't appreciate our teachers, but you guys are the ones shaping who we become as people. As a high schooler, sometimes I wish I had a guide. Somebody to tell me what I should be doing, what choices I should have made. So hopefully these messages from our seniors help you younger guys out, or maybe even older guys.
I think sitting and wasting away in your room, it seems fun in the moment, but you're gonna look back and probably regret it because you don't wanna waste high school sitting and rotting away in your room. You'd be out doing something fun outside, doing nature.
One thing that one of my favorite teachers, Mrs. Feathers, drilled into my head is to focus on what you can control. You can control your opinion of yourself, your actions, your responses, and who you surround yourself with, and that's all that should really matter. All that matters is what you think of yourself and how you present yourself to others.
My name is Landon Weeks, pretty obviously a senior since I'm filming this. So my biggest piece of advice to anyone going through high school would be to make sure your teachers like you. and everything else just gets 1,000 times easier if you manage to do that. So that's what I would say is like the most important thing for high school, or really any part of school.
My grandma's always told me life is about choices, and that's what I'll always live by.
That was good.
And see.
That was great.
Who you surround yourself with. You don't have to surround yourself with a big group of people. You don't have to be ashamed for only having one or two friends. You'll realize, especially as senior year goes on, and even in just all your upperclassmen years, that like who people really are. And you'll want to surround yourself around better people so you also feel better. And you'll really realize that as you get older.
I have two things for advice. One, make sure you have a bomb playlist for high school because you're going to need that for multiple events and some pretty fun car rides. My second piece of advice is you are loved more than this world could ever know. And I wrote something down and it says, you aren't defined by the sports you play, the success you have, or the mistakes you make. You are defined by the love you give, the kindness you show, and the chances that you are willing to take. And just don't get caught up in everything that happened, but just be present and be a light in the world. Be kind, be loving, because a lot of times we focus on the negatives more than the positives, and we need more positives in this world than negative.
It's okay to ask for help sometimes.
My advice for younger girls is to always buy the colorful dress, because you have your entire life to wear a black dress, so wear the colorful dress to prom or to the Christmas dance. And when you're holding your flowers for pictures, hold them down by your waist and not up here. You're paying too much money for a beautiful dress to cover up the top of it, so drop your hands and it'll look better in photos too.
Don't let your home life determine your future success and limit you from accomplishing your dreams. Love you guys.
My advice for anyone going through high school would be to just get involved, do a sport, do the musical, do an art class, do anything to just get involved. Do after school activities, make sure you go to all the dances. You don't want to miss out on anything. So I would say just do it all, even if you don't really want to. Just join everything, join the clubs, just do it all.
Everyone says that they wish they could go back to high school, but I don't think I would want to go back because I don't want to change anything that happened in the past. But I do think that we all are going to go on to bigger and better things in the future, and I'm really excited for everything that my grade has in store for them.
High school might not be the best years of your life, but I promise you it is what you make it. People you meet, friends you make, sports you play, games you win, games you lose, laughing, crying, everything you do at this stage in your life will be improved. Years down the road, some of you may watch this, myself included, in an effort to maybe reflect or show your kids some of your friends, or just maybe you need to remember a class song. I've loved every moment of this time through high school with every one of you. And I know that every one of us is destined for amazing. That being said, here's to the class of 2024.
I watch her go with a certain